Hello once again, everybody, and welcome to McCowan Field in the first round of the South Atlantic Conference Soccer Championships. The women's side, it's the top-seeded Carson-Newman Eagles, the three-time winners of this event here over the last 3 years against the Wingate Bulldogs, seeded eighth in what has been the SAC title match each of the last three seasons, but this year they meet in the opening round. Wingate this year 7-6-2, 4-5-1 in SAC play. Carson-Newman has won six straight. That's the eighth longest streak in the country. Eagles are ranked 16th in the nation. They sealed up their fourth consecutive regular season crown a couple weeks ago, and now trying to their quest for a fourth consecutive tournament title. Eagles became the first team ever in league history to win three straight regular season and three straight tournament titles in a row. Carson-Newman will try to become the first team to win four consecutive SAC tourney titles. Catawba won three straight from 97 to 99. Eagles, of course, riding that three-game streak, and the Bulldogs will try to take care of business, but it'll come here on the road at McCowan Field on a nice early evening for soccer. Eagles will start off by going from left to right here across this pitch that has taken a bit of a beating here of late. Eagles in the gray uniform, tops and bottoms, the white shoulders. Numbers on the front and the back are written in orange with black trim, and the Eagles in script across the back of the uniform top. CN logo in all orange, block on the top left-hand side of the jersey. White socks for the Eagles. Jackie Burns, Carson Newman's keeper. Red socks, black shorts, and a red and black uniform top. Wingate, all blue. Blue socks, blue shorts, blue uniform tops for their kits. Numbers on the front and the back in big, bold, white lettering. Wingate across the back for the Bulldogs and their keeper. Abby Frail, the redshirt senior goalkeeper, 5'9", is in the all pink for the Bulldogs. Carson-Newman coached by Simon Duffy. He's been dominant since he came over here to Carson-Newman from King Duffy with 33 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw in his time for CN. Chip Wiggins mans the other side of the pitch, 9th all-time in the sack and wins 74 of those entering play here today. Do the Bulldogs have an upset in the SAC tournament, or do the Eagles come away and continue their winning streak in the SAC championships? We're underway as Wingate gets the initial touches, but the Eagles promptly take it away. Carson-Newman, one of the higher scoring teams in the country, 17th in that category this season, averaging just under 3 goals per game. Futrell played through into the 18-yard box, taking a couple steps. Left-footed shot, big body save by Frail. Then a right-footed attempt skips wide from Kennedy Rankin after a deflection and goes out for a corner. So here, half minute in, we're already rocking and rolling in this one. Wingate, 5th in the league in terms of scoring offense and 6th in terms of scoring defense. Realisa to take the corner for CN. She'll take the outswinger from this near right corner. Holgram's daughter, the initial target. Talbot Smith, who had the game winner against Catawba on Saturday, was the one that gets the touch. Instead, it's picked up by Krakauer. Looking to counter other Bulldogs. Krakauer charging forward. Plays it into the middle of the field. Couple deflections, slinging out wide now for Williamson. Over a minute played. Eagles with a prime opportunity to start things off, but Frail able to get the save. Down along that right corner, DeLong plays it out of bounds, unable to keep it across the end line. Eagles and Bulldogs meeting for the 36th time. Carson-Newman leads the series 27-6-2, including 4 straight wins since Wingate won 1-0 in 2016. Bulldogs haven't scored against the Eagles since the title match in 2016. That's 3 straight games without a goal. Eagles have outscored the Bulldogs during this 4-game stretch by a 10-1 tally. Masengo will chest it to the ground, then chip it over the head of Holly Talbot-Smith out of play here in the second minute in the SAC tournament opener between these two sides. One game is already finished. LMU with a comeback win against Queens, this 2-seed able to advance. Despite trailing for much of the contest, Lulu fans scored in the 30 seconds into the game, and that lead held until the 76th minute when Cravero for LMU was able to tie it up at one apiece. Talbot Smith sends this one very short. Eagles a couple touches. Masengo hits the outside of the net. Prime opportunity for Carson Newman's leading goal scorer, but it hits the outside of the cage and we remain scoreless. So Cravero scored in the 76th minute for LMU. Went to overtime, and in the initial session, 98th minute, Ballesteros with the winner for the Splitters, and LMU is on to the SAC semifinals. They'll take on the winner of LR and Tusculum on Friday at 1:30 from Rock Hill, South Carolina, where both the men's and the women's sides will converge. Fourth minute of play, Eagles have had a couple prime chances. Haven't been able to finish, however. Futrell hustling after the ball. It's Rankin picking it up, then released a forward for Masengo. Masengo spinning and playing it, looking for Talbot Smith, and it's promptly intercepted by Apicella. Krakauer charges it forward along this near left sideline, picked up by Williamson, but promptly taken off her feet by Cooper. Quick throw in, comes to the middle of the field, picked up by Kimmy Moore, the reigning SAC Offensive Player of the Week announced earlier today. Rankin chips it back. Brandon sends it forward towards midfield. And a high arcing ball again in the center of the pitch. Fourth minute of play, tournament action across the country at all levels in terms of league play. And Carson Newman on its home pitch trying to defend a turf where they've been dominant in, although one of their losses this year came to Tusculum when the Eagles were a player down. Futrell charging forward outside of the 18-yard box, crossing over, playing it for Masengo. Left-footed shot trickles wide, and they do say it was grazed by a bulldog. And here in the fifth minute, Eagles get their second corner. This is what Carson Newman's been striving for, is postseason play. The team that finished second in the nation last year, despite leading for much of the national championship game, conceding a goal with 33 seconds left on the clock. They've been waiting for this opportunity. Hofstetler gets the short corner. Left-footed cross goes for Cooper, and it's over her head and goes out of play for a goal kick. Eagles playing Central Missouri, the two best teams in the nation all year long last year. Carson Newman returned a great deal of those players. The one big missing piece, the All-American, two-time All-American, two-time League Player of the Year in Lauren Wade. But for the most part, the players on this pitch right now, you take out three of them, were in the starting lineup in Kansas City last year for a national championship. So this is what they've been playing for all year long, is to get to postseason play. The one thing that the Eagles do look at, though, potentially this is the only guarantee. It would take a lot for them not to make the NCAA tournament, but if you don't come away with a win in this contest, you certainly leave the fate up to the selection committee. So imperative that the Eagles pick up a victory here. Last week they beat a team that was ranked higher than them, Limestone, who's currently 20th in the country, and then beat Catawba, a team that had put together a really quality campaign and finished the year fifth in the league. At home, stepping forward and sliding it. DiBiase to the middle of the field, picked up by Jendrazik before Hallgrim's daughter pilfers it from her. Realista avoids. DiBiase gives it for Hofstetler. Now Realista slings it to the middle for Hallgrim's daughter. Ball sent well out wide for Futrell. Rankin chips it right back for Futrell. Slide tackle, and getting it right was Hendricks. Before the Eagles concede a throw, is DeLong. Had it bounce off of an Eagle on her ball forward. Header aided along. Couple touches. Williams skies it into the air. Sent right back in the opposite direction. I believe that Moore was offsides as the Eagles now track back to play it. And now the Bulldogs able to start something. But it's promptly given away by Moore before Realista steps to it. Realista, her ball, takes a deflection. Jendrazik, the senior and the team's leading goal scorer, one of 13 players to score this year. for Wingate. Eighth minute of action, scoreless affair. Glad you could join us here on this Tuesday evening. Jefferson City, Tennessee, the site for the activities here in the SAC Women's Soccer Championships 2018 version. Eagles and Bulldogs had met in the last three SAC tournament title games. Carson Newman getting the better of the Bulldogs in those. Carson Newman 5-1 all time when facing Wingate in the SAC tournament championship. The only win for Wingate came back in 1996. That was an opening round effort that the Bulldogs came away with a 2-1 overtime win. Masengo, the target forward, able to take one away, then Realista chips it forward. Great touch by Rankin, looking to play through Talbot Smith. Instead, it's intercepted. Hallgrim's daughter gives it out wide for Huffstetler. Got the left-footed touch right. Plays it forward for Talbot Smith. Back to Huffstetler. Now Masengo tried to get through for Talbot Smith and promptly taken away by Hendricks. But the Eagles still on attack as Hallgrim's daughter angles it back for Williams. Williams with possession. Gives it forward for Futrell. Futrell for Masengo. The ball skies into the air where Futrell touches it. And now Avery Williams sends it for Rankin. Rankin gives it out wide for Brandon. Brandon stopping, starting, sending it along. Nobody in the middle of the field, however, in the ninth minute. And Wingate will now charge back right to left. Eagles with four shots, one on frame. Wingate yet to tally. One of either. These two teams met earlier in the regular season. Carson Newman was the better side. This was just 10 days ago in Wingate, North Carolina. Carson Newman pelting the Bulldogs with 22 shots to Wingate's 8 in that contest. Brandon Masengo, Talbot Smith all scored for Carson Newman. That victory for Carson Newman allowed the Eagles to clinch their fourth consecutive regular season championship. Jackie Burns made just two saves. That's all she needed to do. One shot on frame in each half for Wingate. Frail needed to make 9, and she let 3 slide past her. Long ball looking for Huffstetler, the sophomore racing after it outside of the box. Handling it is DiBiase and giving away a throw for the Eagles in the 10th minute. Do or die for these two sides in the SAC tournament. Good touch played to the middle of the field, but Carson Newman didn't have anybody in gray there. As now Moore steps back to it, tries to play it forward. Instead, it's pilfered by Cooper. Williams, Futrell, able to aid it out wide. Advantage played as Futrell taken to the ground. Brandon has her cross deflected and then cleared forward along the sideline where Avery Williams quickly steps to it. Now Carson Newman will regain its shape. Burns out wide for Williams. Williams, Masengo the intended target. Instead, it comes back out, splitting a pair of central defenders for Carson Newman. Out for Jackie Burns. Cooper with it, right on the center stripe. Picks out Rankin. Talbot Smith touches it, but it evades Masengo as Dendrazik steps to it. And Wingate right now content with just playing long ball after Carson Newman's touches as you see Jackie Burns all the way off of her line. All-region keeper. Hallgrim's daughter out wide for Brandon. Brandon gives it to Futrell. Now back to Brandon. She's charging forward along the far touchline. Brandon into the box, crosses it, looking for Talbot Smith. She got a touch. Realista racing after it. Instead, the header from Williamson goes out of play along this sideline for a throw-in. 12th minute, no score here. You see Brandon's cross from inside of the box. Talbot Smith, the main target, and her touch just couldn't quite angle it on frame. Huffstetler sending it out of bounds, and Carson Newman concedes a goal kick. Eagles have had the field slanted in their direction here early. Wingate in their last 5 road matches, all league action, 0-4-1. They've had one road goal in their last three matches. That was a draw, however, in that span, being outscored this year on the road 10-2 in SAC Road Affairs. 13th minute in a scoreless draw thus far in the SAC quarterfinals. Talbot Smith tried to win possession. Instead, it's taken off of her feet before Huffstetler bangs into Krakauer. Hallgrim's daughter sends it out wide for Futrell. Futrell will chip it for Rankin, and Rankin just couldn't get the black cleat to the ball. Wingate charging forward. Krakauer lobs it along where Williamson can't quite catch it, and Cooper will send it forward for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith able to win her team a throw as she was double-teamed. Talbot Smith had the game winner on Saturday, and she didn't get the game winner last week against Limestone, but her cross into the area resulted in Limestone's failed clearance attempt and an own goal that sent the Eagles to a 1-0 overtime victory. Burns gives it up for Cooper. Cooper gives it out for Alex Brandon. 14th minute of play and a scoreless affair thus far. Cooper will track back to it. Eagles had that early flurry. Masengo hit the outside of the cage from point-blank range. But outside of that, Bulldogs have done a lot of defending, and the Eagles haven't quite been able to solve the mystery of the back line so far for Wingate. Brandon skies one forward, over-released his head. Flag stays down as Wingate able to clear forward. Krakauer overruns the ball, and Huffstetler gets a touch to it before sending it forward for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith picks out Huffstetler. She plays through, looking for Talbot Smith again. She crosses it through the cage, tapped by Masengo, and it goes high. Fantastic combination work by the Eagles, but Masengo just could not quite put it on frame. Great ball across the area, and Masengo's touch just went high. So we stay scoreless. Masengo with two phenomenal chances early on in this one. Her 15 goals are 15th best in the country. Only Abby Brown of Lenore Ryan has more this year in the SAC. Talbot Smith settling it down after the goal kick. Now Huffstetler sees the ball come to her. Couple touches, looking for Rankin in the middle of the field. Now it's cleared towards this sideline. Avery Williams, who has played a ton of minutes in her career, one of the highest marks in the history of the program. Sixteenth minute of a scoreless affair here early on. The other two games going on in the league have begun as well. Those were also 5 o'clock kickoffs. Scoreless Anderson Catawba early, and Lenore Ryan taking on Tusculum in the 3-6 matchup in Hickory. That also scoreless moments in. Here come the Eagles coming back the other way. Futrell clinging to possession and then giving it for Masengo. Her pass just avoids the near right sideline of Talbot Smith, and the clearance comes up here.
I'm good.
Masengo able to get a touch to it. Now Huffstetler gives it for Masengo. Masengo gives it out wide. Futrell actually had to stop it. Now Brandon. Brandon into the area. Crosses it in, and it's taken in by Frail. 17th minute in a scoreless affair thus far. All of the activity has been on that side of the field. High arcing ball coming for Huffstetler. Realista aiding it along. Futrell tries to give it for Rankin. Rankin a transfer for Carson-Newman. Newman. Wingate with one of the few moments of possession here early on in this contest, and they promptly concede it right back to Carson-Newman after the long pass evades a teammate. Pretty decent crowd here early on in this one. Here at McCowan Field, the majority of the other teams around the team are around the campus still practicing. The football team actually right below this. Basketball teams are also practicing as well. Ball comes out to the middle of the field. Realista outlets for Hallgrim's daughter. Now Brandon has to step to it in a rare moment of activity here for Wingate in this first half. Bulldogs have yet to tally a shot here in the opening 19 minutes. Huffstetler for Realista. Realista gives it out wide back for Huffstetler. She shifts it behind her back, evades a defender, gives it for Realista. Rankin, a good touch after canceling out with DiBiase. Now across into the box. Futrell gets a chance. That one's blocked by Chornak. And it comes out. Good bit of defending in the back half by the Bulldogs. Realista spinning over her left shoulder. Going for Talbot Smith. This is where the Eagles have been excellent here in the first half. Talbot Smith will cross it in. Deflected, but right to Realista by Apicella. Now crossed in and then cleared out. Hallgrim's daughter takes a touch to it. Once again, it's cleared, but Huffstetler there. Gives it out wide for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith tries to go back for Huffstetler, who flings it into the middle of the field in a diving attempt taken care of by Kimmy Moore, who had to track all the way back to play it. Now Williamson is whistled for a foul as she's shoving Cooper in the back. And the Eagles will get a free kick right around midfield. Williams takes it quickly, and here come the Eagles again. Brandon and Futrell were both looking at each other for help. Neither one of them took it. And another through ball is intercepted by Chornak. Williams will send it back along. Now Brandon. Brandon gives it out for Cooper. Ahead for Hallgrim's daughter. Now Williams gives it out to the sideline, and Brandon. A rematch of the SAC title match each of the last three seasons. Wingate has been to the title match in 8 consecutive years. Last time they failed to make it to the SAC title match. Was 2009. So a couple substitutions here for Wingate in the 21st minute. Throw comes in quick short, and then it's played out of bounds by DiBiase. DiBiase just couldn't quite get the right touch to it. Hallgrim's daughter for Huffstetler. Now Realista. Nice ricocheting ball for Hallgrim's daughter. Good initial touch by Rankin. Picks out Masengo, who gives it forward for Futrell. Instead, it's pilfered. And now Brandon will send it backwards. 21st minute of play. Masengo getting it right back. Playing very high on the field. Now coming and starting a charge. Brandon outside of the box. Brandon sends it across. Frail with a leaping effort. Now she was able to pick it out of the air with Eagles crashing in on her. So early on here in this one, Carson-Newman, all sorts of pressure, but only one shot on goal here in the early going. Talbot Smith picks out Realista, who charges one down the line. Talbot Smith racing after it. Instead, a pretty good header. Getting it right was Apicella. Throw in from Huffstetler. Talbot Smith for Huffstetler. Now the top of the pitch and Realista. Couple deflections. Rankin comes away with it. Takes a shot, or takes a cross, rather, that's chested to the ground by Hendricks. And Frail able to pick it up. So the Eagles, again, getting inside of the 18-yard box, but Wingate's defending has been on point. Foul whistled here on Huffstetler. She was on Zanardi's back. And a free kick here for Wingate. Moore stands on it and quickly picks out the right-hand side. Had an open teammate. Into Long, who sends it across where Williams is there with the header. Brandon, Rankin. And now Futrell trying to settle it down. Wingate just 3-5 in SAC title matches over that 8-game stretch. Talbot Smith, the picked out target, but evades her, goes out of play. 23rd minute of action, no score, SAC tournament quarterfinals. LMU has already advanced. The 2 seed is into the semifinals. Carson Newman, the top seed in the league, trying to join that party. Things will convene on Friday with a championship on Sunday. Out wide, the ball comes to Zanardi. Zanardi, with a couple defenders in front of her, goes very short for Williamson. Zanardi, the intended target, and Cooper is able to take possession away. Realista along this sideline. Ball slung to the middle, and a foul will be whistled here on Carson Newman. Oh, no, check that. The ball went out of play, rather. Off of the Eagles. Realista comes back for Hufstetler. Now a high arcing ball near side. Nearly comes up here into the booth again as it hits off of the brick facade. Talbot Smith splitting a couple defenders. Left-footed ball seeking Futrell is cleared away by Hendricks. In the middle of the field, and that ignites now a charge the other way, and a foul is whistled on Alex Brandon as she takes a bulldog to the turf. It was Caitlin Cox that was making that charge for Wingate, and now Carson Newman here in the 25th minute, having to do some defending here against the Bulldogs. Rankin for CN on the far sideline. Ball deflected off of her feet by Cox. Comes back out. Wingate has not scored against Carson Newman in the last 3 contests. You look back over the last 3 meetings, the regular season matchup this year, it was a 3-0 Carson Newman win. Last year was a masterclass by Lauren Wade. A hat trick, and Madison Hufstetler adding a 4th goal. That was in the tournament title contest. As Jackie Burns will step out to play this ball. And in the regular season matchup last year, that was in Jefferson City, Carson Newman really controlled the game, 18-3 shots lead, but mustered just a 47th-minute goal from Lara Hallgrim's daughter to win it 1-0. So those are your last 3 matchups here over the last year plus between these 2 sides. Wingate's already brought some substitutions in. Carson Newman has a couple players starting to get loose. Here in the opening quarter of this contest. Hufstetler has it dispossessed, taken away by Chornak, and her ball looking forward goes out of play, and the Eagles will get the throw in. Cooper will take it. Instead, we'll lay it on the ground for Hufstetler. Couple decent touches there by the Eagles, and Realista able to split through a couple Bulldogs. Give it out wide for Brandon. Brandon's initial touch not perfect, but she plays one low on the ground for Futrell, and she bumps over DeLong. No foul whistle. Futrell for Realista, sending it along. Brandon inside the box, plays it back for Talbot Smith, and a quality bit of defending, able to sky it out of play by Apicella. 27th minute in a scoreless effort here in the first half. Carson Newman's men's soccer team will take on Queens at 7:30 this evening. Volleyball team in action against LMU at 7 at Holt Fieldhouse. Rankin cannot win possession as it comes forward for Hallgrim's daughter, who gives it back for Avery Williams. Williams takes a couple steps forward, picks out Futrell. Futrell spins it to the middle of the field and Realista. Good touch out wide for Rankin. Rankin with numbers ahead of her, gets past Apicella, takes a shot. It's blocked by Hendricks and comes out wide. Masango is in the box unmarked, but the angle is cut off. Prompt throw for Realista, who goes to the ground, and a foul is whistled on Kimmy Moore. Not too much disagreement from the Wingate side here in the 28th minute. And the Eagles will get another great opportunity in an attacking position here against the Bulldogs. Hufstetler, Hallgrim's daughter, Realista, all in the area of this free kick. Bulldogs with plenty of blue jerseys in the area. Two defenders in front of Carson Newman's free kick here. Hufstetler steps over it. Hallgrimsdottir does the same. Realista chips it in, and Moore is the first one to get to it for Wingate. Just not enough of an upward trajectory on that cross in by Realista. The Eagles able to maintain possession here. Rankin on the sack logo. Had her pass intercepted. Then Brandon gets her team a throw as Cox defending. Masengo goes to the middle of the field. Futrell making a run, gets bumped off of it. Futrell has possession instead. Will allow it to go across the end line for a corner kick. DiBiase went to the ground, bumping in with Futrell. And Carson Newman adds another corner to the ledger here. It's the third of the match for the Eagles here in the 29th minute. Hallgrim's daughter will tee it up. She'll take it very short. Brandon unmarked at the top of the area. Now she crosses it in over Williams' head. Now Rankin trying to settle it down. Ball juggling between players. Williams there with another high header. Moore holding her headband in her right hand. Heads it. Realista picks out Masengo. Masengo hits it one time and it skips wide. Third prime chance for the senior. And it just did go wide. So great opportunity again for CN. Masengo had the right, not only choice to take it one time, but the right angle. In theory, but just could not quite find a bar on the back post. Realista wins the header, wins another one. Futrell tries to sling it through a couple defenders. Instead, it pops back out. And now Carson Newman has regained some control after Wingate had a couple opportunities in the middle portion of this opening half. Carson Newman 5-1 against Wingate in the SAC tournament. Only loss came 22 years ago in the opening round in 96. Eagles trying to continue that consistent play and vie for a fourth consecutive league tournament title. Just under a quarter of an hour to go here in the first half. Carson Newman with 8 shots, only 1 on frame. Wingate has yet to put one in the books in that category. Burns stepping out to pick it up and lob it forward, looking for Brandon, trying to start a break. Brandon for Masengo. Masengo steps on the ball and is able to win it. She's on her defensive half of the field now and can try to pick something out in front of her. Ball out wide for Brandon. Brandon for Futrell. Futrell can't evade a defender. Futrell for Rankin. One touch along. Realista the intended target. Moore defensively able to win possession. Now Cox strikes it, or is the intended target of this strike. Cox takes it, turning over her right shoulder. Coming back to the middle of the field. And Zickert plays it between a couple Carson Newman defenders, and this one will go all the way towards the end line where Jackie Burns rescues it before going out of play. Now Burns will pick it up inside of her area. Then roll it back to the ground as Wingate starts to settle back in. Defensively, Burns sends it forward, and nobody in particular in mind is Apicella able to take it away. There you go, let's go. Carson Newman had won 25 consecutive regular season contests until Tusculum won on this facility earlier this month. Eagles and Bulldogs are scoreless here in a rematch of the last 3 SAC tournament title contests. Cooper stepping to it and hitting it out of play. Substitutions again. Wingate likes to go deep into that bench. Morgan Gray is into the contest. She replaces DeLong. So Gray back in, or in for the first time, rather, with 12 and a half minutes to go in the first half. Talbot Smith can't control possession. Now Moore sends it forward, and the Eagles again able to regain some possession. Burns at the top of the 18-yard box. Picks out Brandon with an excellent ball forward. Futrell in the middle of the field, it's Cox. Williams stepping to it and taking it away. Williams sends it along this middle of the field. Apicella overruns it, but gets it right back. Holgram's daughter has it bang off of her back, and Cooper now sends it along this sideline. Released it, nods it along. Now Elena Probst picks it up. Left-footed ball for Talbot Smith. Back out wide for Realista, sends it looking for Talbot Smith, and instead, nobody playing that ball as it goes out for a goal kick. Thirty-fourth minute of play here. Carson Newman has controlled the tempo of this contest, has gotten some prime opportunities, but the Eagles unable to break through here at this juncture. Wingate doing a lot of defending against the 16th-ranked team in the country. With just under 11 minutes to go in the first half, Bulldogs, let's see if they might have a stunner in terms of a counterattack, or does Carson Newman find a net? Rankin with it in the middle of the field. Sends it between a couple defenders, and Frail again there to pick it up. First meeting this year, Carson Newman struck in the 9th and 14th minutes, so they were off and rolling to an early lead. They scored with just over a half minute to go in the contest. And that was their three goals back on October 20th, so 10 days ago. Futrell sending it back, a couple touches here in the middle of the field. Now Masengo hustling after it, but a good diving effort by Chornak. Cooper with a high header towards the sideline. Eagles with another couple substitutions getting loose. Probst has already come in. Jaden Zaff and Sydney Spatafora are getting some stretching in as a foul whistled on Cox. And the Eagles have Christina Markfort waiting at the assistant official. Eagles will take this free kick. Holgram's daughter gets it back for Cooper. Cooper will send it back for Jackie Burns. Burns to the middle of the field and Holgram's daughter. Holgram's daughter for Brandon. Brandon able to elude a defender, and here comes Carson Newman on the charge again. Futrell, however, can't get the wheels to pick up to that ball as Hendricks picks it up and now substitutes a plenty on each side. Markfort will come in, and Holly Talbot-Smith will get the break. And Cox will come off, and Savannah Metz will come back in. Masengo to the middle of the field looking for Markfort. Now the ball's sliced long. Cooper gets a touch to it. Shaky bit of defending for the moment as Metz was there looking to strike. Brandon, high arcing ball. Masengo on sides, but Frail, alert, and able to come off of her line to get to that ball. 8.5 minutes to go in the first half. Carson Newman trying to pick out a contest opening goal. Probst watches the ball bounce behind her. Then Avery Williams high arcs it forward. Couple headers, picks out Masengo. Masengo settles it down, finds Realista. Realista looking to find Futrell. Futrell hustling after it, gets a touch. Empty net with Frail diving to it. And then the ball crushed out wide. Very good defending at the last moment to clear that one away. And it had to be right on the back half by Morgan Gray. And she had the pace to get there after Futrell had the initial touch with an empty net. Blackburn and Spatafora are in for Carson-Newman. Masengo and Futrell get breathers. So Carson-Newman's potency in terms of season goals finds its way onto the bench as Realista to take the corner. Hits it to the back post over Williams and Spatafora, and a handball whistled on Mark Fort, who was the intended target on the back half of that corner kick. Eagles still with that 8-0 shots lead, but only one on frame. Masengo had a couple dazzling chances early, but never could quite put the ball in the net. Missed wide off the outside of the cage, missed high on a cross into the middle, and then punched one left of the left bar. Williams gets a touch out wide, pokes it forward for Alex Brandon. Brandon sends it for Mark Fort, the big midfielder for CN. Eagles trying to tuck back defensively as Cooper gets a touch. Sends it forward for Spatafora. Back for Brandon here in the SAC Tournament quarterfinals. Blackburn, good touch on the outside of her foot. But Spatafora will not have the wheels to catch up to this one as Frail strikes it to midfield. Couple touches bouncing around. Brandon, Mark Fort. In the middle of the field, Gray sends it where it takes a couple touches. And Zanardi sends it out wide looking for Metz. But Cooper is there. Gives it back for Jackie Burns. Burns with two players in the immediate area in terms of Wingate jerseys, forced to just send it long. Brandon and now Hallgrim's daughter getting touches. And it comes for Spatafora, back for Avery Williams in the final 5.5 of the opening portion of this contest. Williams nods it back along, Spatafora chests it to the ground. Brandon over Mark Ford's head. Couple touches in midfield, and Wingate starting to hold some possession as Carson-Newman's made some substitutes. Propes redirects it out towards the sideline. Cooper hits it into the air. Substitute for Carson-Newman. Jane Zapf will come in, and Hallgrim's daughter will come out, so the Eagles making their fair share of changes now as Propes throws it. Propes takes it here in the middle of the field. Under 5 minutes to go in the first half. Carson-Newman looking to break through here in the SAC Tournament quarterfinals. Elsewhere, LR and Tusculum are still knotted at zero. About 10 minutes to go in that first half. Catawba has taken the lead on Anderson. Shelby Vosic with the goal for Catawba in the 18th minute has the 5 seed leading the 4 seed. The winner of that contest will get the winner of this one, either top-seeded Carson-Newman or 8th-seeded Wingate. Williams on the outside for Carson-Newman, pedaling forward and striking it. Over 6,000 minutes in her career, 5th on the program's all-time ledger in that category is Williams. Propes pass, trying to pick out. Rankin was intercepted. And now Zanardi will come back in the other direction. Spatafora touches it out wide. But they say it was last touched by Apicella. Now Carson-Newman adds another substitute to the mix. Lauren Hattery will come in, and Kennedy Rankin will get the breather. Spatafora along this near right sideline. Realista chips it along. Comes right back out to the middle of the field, and Realista actually the first one to get to it before Wingate again touches it towards this sideline. Cooper watches it go across the touchline with 3 minutes to go here in the opening 45. Probst, as she was just about to take it a few yards in front of where the official liked, the official makes her step back. Mark Fort plays it back for Probst. Ball goes through the middle of the field, and it's intercepted. Taken away by Zickert. Zickert charging among a couple Carson-Newman defenders. Touches it, then gets pushed to the ground by Cooper, and no foul. Whistled on the Eagles in what has been a fairly clean opening 45. Cooper puts it to the middle of the field, and Realista. Realista goes to the far sideline, and Brandon. Brandon taking a couple steps forward and finds Blackburn. Blackburn tries to go through the legs of a defender, and that defender falls down, and the official will stop play with the ball at midfield. I believe that perhaps the kick caught a bit of the shin or maybe stepped on the foot of Gray there near midfield. And that will require some medical attention. Each of these coaches not really overly judicious in terms of decision-making in terms of subs. Eagles have made 6 changes. Bulldogs have made 7. So plenty of substitutes for each side here in this first half. Carson-Newman ranked 16th in the country. Region rankings come out tomorrow, the final ones before the NCAA tournament. Carson-Newman trying to be one of the top 2 teams to host. Columbus State, you would feel like, has all but assured itself of doing just that, one of the longest winning streaks in the country, beat North Georgia on Saturday 4-1. So the Cougars in a prime spot to host that first weekend and then be the home team when the clubs converge in the South for the region championship before the national quarterfinals. Gray needing some extra bit of assistance to come off the field here. And you would think that they would need to make a substitution. Indeed they will. Erica Pacello will be the one to come in. She'll be the 8th substitute for Wingate here in the opening half. I believe your only players that are left from the starting lineup are Chornak, Moore, and the keeper, Frail. Oh, Apicella out there as well. Burns, poor pass, didn't quite have the elevation, but unable to be settled down by Zanardi, and she promptly gives it away, and here come the Eagles again. Realista to the middle of the field, and Mark Ford, her touch not exactly right, and Blackburn unable to win possession. Left-footed ball slicing towards the sideline. One touch and keeping it in play. Zanardi. Zanardi sends it along towards this sideline where Cooper able to defend for the moment as Metz is hustling after it. But now Burns with a right foot this time. Cycles it out where Mark Fort chips it along for Brandon. 90 seconds to go in the first half. Eagles and Bulldogs in the opening round of the SAC tournament are scoreless. Avery Williams has possession. Picks out Jaden Zaff, now for Realista, sends it along for Probst. Probst steps on the ball, can't quite get her momentum rolling. Final 70 seconds here in the 44th. Realista for Blackburn. Blackburn picks out Hattery, and Apicella takes it away, and a foul will be whistled on Carson-Newman as we wind under a minute to go. This will be a free kick here for Apicella. 3/4 of a minute left in the first half. And now Frail will be the one to take it here in the final 38 seconds. Wingate certainly wants this to be the last chance for either side here in the opening 45 minutes. Ball coming forward from Frail in the final 25. Eagles win the initial header in Mark Fort. The 6'1 German international Now Blackburn hustling after it with 15 seconds left. Blackburn taking off the ball, 14 and 13 as it goes out of play with 12 and 11. 10, quick throw needed nine, here by the Eagles. Seven seconds left, comes to the middle of the field. Realista takes a shot on, it goes high, and that is how the first half comes to a close. And if you're eighth-seeded Wingate, you feel happy about the first 45 minutes. You conceded twice in the opening, 14 minutes in the regular season meeting this year, but through 45 minutes here at McCowan Field, despite not taking a shot whatsoever, it is scoreless. Carson Newman just one shot on goal, eight total shots, and the Eagles and the Bulldogs are deadlocked here at halftime. Been a dandy. If you like a tight contest and some defending from both sides, but Carson Newman will try to right the ship in the second half. Wingate, see if they can get some offense rolling. 45 minutes in the books, 45 to go in a scoreless affair in the SAC quarterfinals. Carson Newman, the top seed, and the Wingate Bulldogs, the 8th seed. We'll come back with more here in a moment on the Eagles Sports Network. Back to McCowan Field as we get the start of the second half. SAC Tournament Quarterfinals here at McCowan Field. Elsewhere in the league, LR Tusculum scoreless at the break. Catawba leads Anderson 1-0 at halftime. Already seen some dramatics in the league. LMU winning in overtime, overcoming a 1-0 deficit to beat Queens. So the 2 seed is in to the SAC semifinals. Now can Carson Newman, the top seed, the 3-time defending champions, knock off a pesky 8th-seeded Wingate group? Can the offense get rolling for the Eagles, or does Wingate continue to do a stout job defensively from their half of the pitch? This is the seventh all-time meeting between these two programs in the SAC tournament. Eagles have won all but one of the first six. We're underway here in the second half. Carson Newman and its 4-3-3 attack, the exact same as we started here earlier. DeLong plays it forward. Wingate did not register an official shot in the opening three quarters of an hour in this contest. Eagles on the other side had 9, but only one required a save. They did hit one over the bar, to the left of the bar, and off the side of the cage. So had some chances to break through, but just never could. Rankin gives it for Realista. Realista clashes out with Kimmy Moore. Now the Eagles will start something up as Brandon has it taken off of her feet by DeLong. Bulldogs charging forward as this ball from Cox will be stepped to by Avery Williams. Williams cannot quite maintain possession. Now slides it back for Jackie Burns, who gets her clearance correct. Ball skips up. Looked like it hit the hand. Official says no thank you on any kind of a foul call. As this ball ricochets off of a couple bodies. Last touched by Alex Brandon, and the Bulldogs maintain some possession. Certainly, if you're Wingate, you'd like to find something here of a surge early in this half. Trying to catch the Eagles off guard before CN can start to lock in. Masengo picks out Rankin, making a run into the sun area, left side of the field. She steps into the box, plays it for Talbot Smith. Her redirect spikes off of the ground, and Frail scoops it up. Talbot Smith with the opportunity, trying to put the Eagles on the board first. Just could not quite get it right. Scoreless affair here in the 47th minute. Carson Newman and Wingate, they're familiar with each other without question. They've met in the tournament title match each of the last 3 years. Bulldogs have been there 8 straight seasons. But Carson Newman on the other side has been the victor each of the last 3 years in the title match. DeLong strikes it four. Now Cooper will take a couple steps forward to play it. Huffstetler will send it all the way to the back, and Jackie Burns. 48th minute, no score. Carson Newman, Wingate. SAC Tournament Quarterfinals. The right to get to Manchester Meadows in Rock Hill, South Carolina, is on the line between these two sides. Foul whistled on the Eagles. And it'll be a free kick here that Apicella will take for Wingate. Hits this one forward. It's off the back of Holgram's daughter, who turned to face the goal. Lights are lit here at McCowan Field, but not taking any bit of an effect at this juncture in the contest. You can see the shadows very long where Jackie Burns is. The sun is beaming right into the eyes of Frail, the Wingate keeper. Moore plays this one forward. Eagles tracking after, and it's actually Jackie Burns, the keeper for CN, who is yet to really be challenged, but has had a lot to do in her defending. Masengo with a redirect. Futrell will give chase, but now it goes out of play. Temperatures to start the day were excellent. Temperatures in the low 60s on a very fine day for soccer. But as we get into the night and the longer this one goes, the temperature will continue to dip. Could trend down towards the 40s. Cooper hits it along for Holgram's daughter. Rankin has the ball slide through her legs. Bulldogs controlling a little more possession now. Long ball that Cooper will be able to get to and ensure that it does not go out of play for the time being. And now it officially does, and the Eagles will take a goal kick.
Come on, Alex. Alex, up you get, up you get.
50th minute, scoreless affair. Williams has it along the sideline, hits it forward, and it's intercepted by DeLong. DeLong to the top of the area. Nobody there defensively, and now Carson Newman able to track to it as Williamson was taking a heavy touch. Things starting to open up here for Wingate. And a foul will be whistled. And Carson Newman will get a free kick. Plenty of holdovers over the years between these two sides. Carson Newman has been the better of the two in the all-time series. Has really dominated things between these two programs. But the Bulldogs looking good through the first 50 minutes. Do the Eagles have a strike? One of the highest scoring teams in the country. Right around 3 goals per match this year. Relisa for Holgram's daughter. Futrell was trying to turn with it. Instead, DeLong took it off of her feet. Middle of the field, the ball goes, cycling to her right-hand side before picking out Apicella with Chornak. Long ball for Huffstetler as she heads it along. Released out wide for Talbot Smith. Couldn't quite ignite the offense for the time being before flaring it for Masengo. Out wide for Rankin. Rankin sends one high into the air. Ball bouncing around. Now Futrell will send it along, and the flag will go up here for offsides as Talbot Smith and Masengo were in prime position to put our first goal on the board, but the duo were both standing in offsides positions. 52nd minute of what right now is a scoreless affair in the tournament.
Where was the offside?
Brandon is way for Futrell. Then Futrell has Brandon, who continued along a run. Gets the initial touch right. Now crosses it in. Low liner looking for Rankin, and a great redirect by Apicella. Eagles not done yet. Talbot Smith into the middle. Headed out by Chornak. And then one out by Marshall. Marshall slings it along. Cooper will step to it. Misplayed it. Holgram's daughter is able to win some jostling near midfield. Cooper triple teamed and concedes possession. It's taken away by Marshall. Now the ball comes forward for Cox. Two defenders on her. Cox forced to go out towards the sideline. Williams bumping around with her. Williams goes to the ground, and a foul will be called as Williams was jostling with Cox. 53rd minute. Are we going to need some added time? Plenty of real estate left in this contest. But the Eagles have not quite been able to click from an offensive perspective. Talbot Smith in the middle of the field. Splits a double team. Has Masengo making a run. Instead, it's Rankin. Rankin picks out Masengo now. Masengo plays it through the middle. Talbot Smith took a shot, and it takes a redirect and goes out of play. DiBiase in defense, and he'll go for a corner kick. Carson Newman will get its fifth. Eagles here in the 54th minute will get a great opportunity to try to get on top in this one. Carson Newman, 10 shots, 2 on frame. Wingate still with 0. Realista will take the corner kick. Strikes it, goes back post with it. Williams wins the header, but angles it out wide. And it goes for a goal kick here for Wingate. Krakauer is back in for the Bulldogs. She comes back in and replaces Cox in the Wingate lineup. 55th minute of a scoreless affair here in the SAC quarterfinals. The right to get to Rock Hill, where the semifinals and championship will be played on the line. Realista has her ball deflected, but now Hufstetler steps forward. Hallgrim's daughter strikes it towards the top of the box. Headed out of there by Hendricks. Then the ball ricochets off of Realista. Realista gets a header to it. Masengo tried to settle it down, but Hendricks went high with it with a head. Hallgrim's daughter trying to take possession. Instead, it's struck forward for Cooper. Cooper evading a defender and picking out Futrell. Futrell for Masengo. Masengo tried to peel it forward for Talbot Smith. Instead, it was taken away. Hufstetler out wide for Futrell. Futrell looking over her left shoulder, hits it out wide. High header will go out of play by DiBiase for a throw in here for the Eagles. Hufstetler will take the toss here in the 56th minute. Lob comes for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith touches it for Rankin. Rankin takes a shot that hits Apicella and is cleared out by Wingate. Now Carson Newman starting to apply pressure as Cooper couldn't quite settle it down, and the Eagles had plenty of numbers. Carly Olson, for the first time in this match, will come into the contest. She replaces Marshall in the lineup. And a throw-in coming here for Wingate here in the 56th. Short toss comes in, a couple touches. Eagles have applied some pressure here over the last couple minutes, and Rankin couldn't quite maintain possession. Krakauer picks out the right-hand side and Williamson. Williamson being defended by Williams. Clearance attempt is not quite handled by the Eagles, and then a shot from Olsen, freshly entered, falls into the hands of Jackie Burns. So 57th minute is when we see Wingate's first shot attempt. And Jackie Burns comes away with a save, and the Eagles now trying to press in the other direction. The top seed keeping the number 8 team in the league around here. Futrell has some space, picks out Realista. Realista with her touch, a little too heavy, given away, but the Eagles get it right back. Hufstetler, her pass evaded Hallgrim's daughter, and it's taken away, and here come the Bulldogs again in the all blue. Williams is there with too much strength to take it away, and a foul is whistled. Williams does an excellent job against the redshirt freshman, the senior winning the battle, and now Carson Newman in the 58th minute. We'll get another free kick. Avery Williams, looked like she was going to take it. Now does take it. Give it over to Cooper. Everybody for the Eagles on that side of the field, minus Burns as it comes across. Talbot Smith the touch. A redirect goes out, heading towards giving Carson-Newman a corner, but instead it is saved by the Bulldogs and hit out wide by DiBiase. Eagles take the throw, looking for Masengo. Headed out again by DiBiase. Now Realista takes a shot on high, arcing, and it just goes wide. Nearly a golden strike from Realista. Take a look at the replay, and that ball was high arcing and did not miss by much. Frail was leaping into the air, and she was never going to get a piece of it, and the Eagles with a prime chance on a dazzling ball from the senior, but kept out of net yet again. 59th minute and no score. Apicella, poor pass, gives way for Futrell, who's played off of it by DiBiase, and it goes for a throw-in for CN. Look like Carson-Newman has turned it up a notch here as Masengo, her redirect comes into the middle. Wingate doing a lot of this, just trying to sky the ball forward and get it out of harm's way. Eagles have had the answers, however. Released a couple touches. Now it comes back to the middle of the field. Apicella skies it out, and it'll trickle out of play along that far sideline. Now the sun starting to continue to dip below the horizon as Realista goes to the ground. Masengo will be able to pick it up. Masengo providing some dribbling skills before it comes out for Rankin. Now here's Brandon. Brandon looking to her left-hand side, has Talbot Smith over there, gets it right back. Brandon will turn to her right-hand side. Brandon puts it in. Masengo with a redirect touch. You see it sidewinding on the ground. And Wingate's able to evade pressure for the time being. Hustling after it is Krakauer. Krakauer plays it in the middle, and here's the counterattack from Wingate. Burns is way off of her line. And if Williamson decides to strike it, she might have been able to beat Burns, who was playing way outside of the 18-yard box. But here in the 60th minute, Wingate trying to build things up. Cooper watches the ball play, and it comes back for Burns. Burns gets a touch and skies it out of there from her 6-yard box. Moore now hits one and certainly never gave a shot attempt a chance as Burns plays it for Cooper. Cooper back for Burns. Burns hits it forward. Talbot Smith was turning with it. Poor clearance. Rankin for Masengo. Masengo, ball comes out. Good bit of defending by Wingate, but Brandon is there, and she has some pace behind her, but her touch lets her down, and it goes out of play by DeLong. And it's a throw after it did graze Brandon's foot for Wingate. 61st minute of what right now stands as a scoreless affair. Williams hits one high into the air, released a tracking for it. Ball comes out towards the middle of the field. Futrell is there after trying to shield off a defender was Olsen. Cooper looks to her right-hand side, gives it over for Futrell. Futrell breaking the ankles of one defender, plays it for Rankin. Rankin, good bit of dribbling exhibition there, but instead it's taken off of her feet by the Bulldogs. Catawba continues to lead Anderson in the 55th minute. 56th minute in Hickory, and LR and Tusculum are scoreless. So tight affairs across the league. LMU has already advanced with an overtime win against Queens. And the Royals, after making it to the tournament last year, are out of the picture here this season. 62nd minute in a scoreless outing thus far. 13-1 shots favor for CN, but only two of those 13 have been on frame. Plenty of near misses for the Eagles. Williams hits this one very short. It skips around. Talbot Smith stepping on it, giving it over for Brandon. Brandon outside of the box, crosses it through. Masengo redirect, and it goes wide. Apicella. Or check that. That was Kimmy Moore, who was stepping in defensively. And she provided just enough of a shield in front of Masengo. And Carson Newman, another great opportunity, trying to pick out their leading goal scorer, who has 15 of them on the year. Come on, 63rd minute. Eagles and Bulldogs locked into another classic. Olsen charges it to the middle of the field, and Brandon. Brandon has it dispossessed off her feet. Now you can really start to feel like Wingate feels like the door is open for an opportunity to strike. The long to the middle of the field. Williams, however, skies this one forward, released it, nods it along. Rankin looking after it, and we get a foul whistled on Wingate. And Carson Newman will take a free kick. You hear it all the time. When you're the better team on paper, the longer you keep the opponent around, the more and more they start to believe like they can get out of here with a positive result. And certainly for the Eagles, on paper, the better side. The one seed. Wingate is the eight. Masengo with good technique to take the ball away. She's outside of the box, however, along this near left sideline. Masengo probing, picking out Brandon. Brandon will step to the line now, and she will win her team a corner kick with a deflection. Sixth corner of the contest for Carson Newman. Realista will take another. And you wonder if the Eagles do anything differently here. They've played the ball back to Brandon outside of the box a couple times. They've gone back post plenty of times as well. See what Realista elects to do here in the 65th minute. She hits this one to the top of the box. It's headed across the area. Williams whiffs on a redirect chance and then goes to a slide tackle to concede a goal kick. And more substitutes here for Wingate. They love that deep bench. Metz and McCollum. Of the players listed on their roster, all but two have played at least a game this year. So it's a team that certainly likes to go as deep into the arsenal as they can possibly go for Chip Wiggins. Realista heads the goal kick as this now goes wide. Carson Newman gets another throw. Eagles have not been without great opportunities, but haven't quite been able to really put together a strong flurry or a brilliant finish. Realista, Rankin, out wide, Brandon. Now Masengo. Masengo cycles it forward. Talbot Smith tries to pick out Futrell. Futrell between two defenders. Ball's loose. Futrell to the ground. And instead it's DiBiase that wins it. Masengo inside the box still. Masengo, left-footed attempt, redirected around. Ball pinging in the box. DiBiase again with the header and finally cleared forward by Wingate. Williams sends it right back along. Header goes to the middle of the field. Futrell hustling after it and will win it. Futrell able to get there. Realista sends it for Masengo. Masengo turning and chipping it into the box, and Frail is there as Rankin, the intended target there from Masengo. 67th minute. Carson Newman and Wingate are scoreless in the SAC quarterfinals. Eagles the one seed, Bulldogs the eight. Wingate is winless in its last five road trips. They have not beaten a SAC team on the road this year. Wingate in those contests being outscored 10-2. Cross comes over, Burns coming out. She's diving after it and picking it up from Zanardi. Now trying to start things off as she gets it for Brandon. Brandon beats DeLong. Brandon goes over the head of Rankin, however. Realista charging after it, gives it over for Huffsettler. You can feel the sense of urgency starting to tick up between these two sides. Moore bouncing it around. Futrell's able to win it, picks out Brandon. Brandon, right-footed ball over for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith tried to chip it along, but Hendricks is there. Towards midfield. Eagles do have a couple substitutes waiting as Cooper unable to initially cleanly play it. now indeed does so for Burns. Three defenders around her as Burns gives it out for Realista. Realista charges it along to the sideline, and Hufstetler. Hufstetler gives it for Rankin. Rankin, the ball skips up into her body. Now Metz. Metz has it deflected. Masengo sends it out wide. Futrell couldn't quite get the initial touch, but she is able to settle it down. Goes for Masengo. Masengo for Rankin. Rankin, right-footed shot attempt, saved by Frail's left hand, and cleared forward. What a save by Frail. Got a piece of it with the left hand. Eagles not done yet, however. Talbot Smith gets a touch to it, sends it back for Rankin. Rankin for Brandon. Brandon looking, taking a couple extra touches. Right-footed shot will slice wide and out of play. Take a look back at this opportunity. Rankin with a shot, and that left arm of Frail just able to get up there and poke it away as she was diving to her right-hand side. Sixty-ninth minute of a scoreless game. Masengo hustling into the area. Got a piece, but Frail again able to win possession here in the 70th minute. Masengo starting to take over now for the Eagles. Futrell. Realista. Moore falls to the ground defending. Goes to Futrell, and she is offsides as she skies it looking for Probst. Futrell thought that she was being held up along that sideline, but the officials do not whistle as such. Carson-Newman offsides for the second time in this one. 70th minute, we tick down towards the end of regulation here in what right now stands as a 0-0 contest. Wingate has not scored against Carson-Newman since the 2016 season in the SAC title match when the Eagles won that contest 2-1. Bulldogs have a couple more players coming back in. Marshall and Cox are back in for Wingate as the revolving door on that sideline continues to open for the Bulldogs, and that's certainly one thing that you look at. They are able to keep themselves very fresh. Bulldogs have just one shot in this one. Jackie Burns saved it. Realista looking for Futrell, and eludes her touch. Now Hufstetler chesting it to the ground. It comes all the way back. Burns will step off of her line, come out to the top of the 18-yard box, and pick it up. Burns, the Northern Ireland international, will now spin it forward. Markfort couldn't win the header. It's Moore instead that does so. Hallgrim's daughter bodying up. Now Williams for Brandon. Back to Hallgrim's daughter. Now again, it's the senior Brandon looking forward and then sending it along as two bodies crash into each other. Cox gets the touch for Wingate as they look to ignite things, and Williams, as she has so often done in her career, gets the defense right. Probst for Brandon. Brandon spins it, ball bouncing around. Along this sideline, the ball cycles forward. It gets a touch. Burns will step off her line and just take it one time to clear it out towards midfield. Moore heads it, but in the wrong direction. Futrell and Apicella bang into each other. And now Markfort comes out wide looking for Brandon, and she doesn't quite have the pace along this sideline. 73rd minute. Eagles have had some bursts at times, have had some opportunities, but just unable right now to fully solve the puzzle. Mark Fort plays it for Masengo. Masengo takes it with the left foot, and it beats Frail. And Carson Newman finally breaks through in the 73rd minute. The Eagles take the lead behind Masengo's 16th. So it's Magda Masengo, who this year has four game winners. Is that a fifth? Or now does Wingate find an equalizer? They have not been very attacking in this one. Now they're forced to, with 17 and a half minutes to go in what could be their final game of the season, unless they're able to find a goal. They have to find the answer now. 73rd minute. Eagles leading it 1-0. Masengo on a sequence that almost sprouted out of nowhere. Moore able to win possession, but all she could do is hit it out of bounds. Eagles now will certainly look to take as much time as they possibly can. But do the Bulldogs, a team that from an offensive perspective this year scored just twice on the road against SAC teams, do they have a goal? 74th minute. Mark Fort, certainly Wingate right now, has upped the intensity. Cooper along the far right sideline, stings it forward over the head of Futrell. Apicella sends it back. It's a giveaway. Masengo with a touch. 1v1. Beats the keeper. She will walk it in for her second goal in a matter of moments. And the Eagles lead it 2-0. It is her 17th. And that reminiscent of a goal that she scored against West Florida in the national quarterfinals last year. A defensive giveaway by the Bulldogs. And Masengo in the right spot, and then pure class with the first touch and then beating Frail, and she just walked it in. Got into the 6-yard box and was able to strike it into the net. Those goals for Masengo coming just a few moments apart. Alex, you need to watch here. Elena, you're going to have to track back and cover, put in a shift. 16-17 now left, and the top seed has taken firm control of this one. And now Wingate can really sell out. Bulldogs can try to find the response. Probst turning, stopping on a dime. So those goals coming less than 90 seconds apart, 87 ticks apart from each other for Masengo. And certainly you feel like one of those two are the fifth game winner, with Wingate only mustering one shot all game. Futrell along the sideline, touches it for Realista. Realista with a couple touches, picks out Masengo again. Masengo, a bit of defending to at least get it away from her for Hufstetler. Hufstetler goes left to right, behind her back, getting bodied up, then sending it back for Cooper. Cooper chips this one, but it'll go out of play. Catawba still clinging to a lead on Anderson, under 20 minutes to go there from Anderson, South Carolina. And we're still scoreless, Tusculum and LR. So as of right now, it'd be Carson Newman and Catawba, a rematch of the regular season finale in the semifinals. But we still have a quarter of an hour to sort through things here. Jackie Burns, who more than likely will leave Carson Newman as the all-time leader in conference history in terms of shutouts. She only needs a few more to get past there. She's passed Alexis Jones, Wingate's phenomenal keeper, as now things are opening up. Williams can't get the touch right. Right-footed shot. Beats Burns. and goes into the net. Jendrazik pulls the Bulldogs one closer. So Jendrazik gets the goal. It is her fifth of the year. And we have seen three goals now after we had seen none in the first 72 minutes. Three goals in the last 5 minutes. And Carson Newman, after it looked like it was in complete control, just a poor defensive effort. Giving it away in the back, and Wingate, who has scored just twice on the road this year against SAC schools, has picked up a goal to pull it one closer. And the Bulldogs can continue to sell out. So the Eagles making some mistakes. All in the middle of the field, a couple touches, looking to the middle is Moore. Moore with Mark Fort defending her. Moore goes out wide, one touch. Hallgrim's daughter stepping to it. Bodies bumping into each other. Now a right-footed shot attempt that Burns will watch go out wide off of the foot of Marshall. 13:40 to go. So after Carson Newman seizing control to take a 2-0 lead, Jendrazik's fifth goal of the year makes it a one-goal contest. Williams for Carson Newman. Eagles would certainly like to add a little bit more and get that cushion back up to two. Wingate on the other side has started to press forward. Probst plays it back for Brandon, who skies it looking for Talbot Smith. Frail is off of her line. Frail had to get the touch right and was able to do so, but Probst bodying up at least forces a little bit of pressure and gets the possession. Mark Fort skies one along. Probst making the run outside of the box. Able to haul it in on the grass. Now cycle it through the middle of the field before it's taken away and cleared forward by Zanardi. Zickert has it taken away by Williams. Williams hustling down the sideline. Left-footed cross attempt goes out along this near touchline for a throw. 12.5 minutes to go in regulation. Eagles now clinging to a 2-1 lead. Brandon to take the toss. Brandon comes backwards for Hallgrim's daughter. Hallgrim's daughter strikes it, top of the area. Talbot Smith with a flick on. Rankin looking to get to it. And it goes out. Last touch by Wingate for a corner kick. 12 minutes remain in regulation. 16th ranked Carson Newman, the top seed in the SAC tournament, has the lead on a quest for a fourth consecutive tournament championship. They have four straight regular season titles. And now, Realista tying her shoe, they force the clock to stop here for the time being. And now, Realista will send this one in near post over Williams and Talbot Smith. And cleared out of trouble. Hofstetler racing after it. She'll get to that one and then fall to the ground. And by doing so, the ball juggles around. Cooper spins it out wide for Realista and evades her. And a substitution. Wingate comes back with the long. And she replaces the goal scorer, Jendrazik. So she'll get a quick breather here, with over 11 minutes remaining in this one. An Eagle win, they go to the semifinals. A Bulldog equalizer forces overtime unless a team finds a winner. A Bulldog win would end a string of three straight tournament championships for the Eagles and knock off the one seed. Couple touches in the middle of the field, it's Hofstetler. Hofstetler bouncing around. All in the middle of the area, flipped out wide, hustling after it, and Williamson. Williams on her defensively for CN. Williamson comes to the middle of the field, One touch from Zickert, crosses it over, looking for the head of Marshall, who couldn't quite get to the top of it. And it goes out of play for a goal kick here for Carson Newman. Eagles trying to close things down.
Wider, Alex. Wider, Alex. Yeah,
but Carson Newman has the one-goal lead. Masengo scoring twice in 87 seconds. With the one goal coming back from Wingate. Long ball splitting a couple defenders. Burns comes out and scoops it up. And then a little left-handed baseball toss forward. Looking for Cooper. Mark Fort back for Cooper. Cooper in the middle of the field. Goes out wide for Realista. Picks out Rankin along the sideline. And gets her team a throw in with 9.5 minutes to go. All the pressure on the Eagles now to hold this advantage. Lenore Ryan has scored in Hickory to take a lead on Tusculum. Bears able to get the goal. It comes from Hannah Van Eerden. She strikes for LR. And right now it's one goal leads across the board in the three games remaining.
Come on, ladies, let's go.
LMU has advanced with an overtime winner. Mark Fort plays one through, looking for Rankin, a slide tackle. Getting it right was DiBiase. Hitting it out of play, and a corner kick coming here for Carson Newman in the 82nd minute. And Realista will gladly take her time to get over there. Realista jogging very slowly to get to this ball. Has already wasted about 20 seconds by doing so. Now we'll tee it up. Realista to strike it, goes to the back post. It's over a couple bodies, ball loose in the area as it comes out wide and is now crushed forward where Williams sends it back along. Eagles have had 8 corners in this one but haven't been able to capitalize on those. Williams for Cooper. Now back for Hufstetler. Instead it's given way to Avery Williams in the final 7 3/4 minutes of regulation. Burns will get a right-footed touch, go to her right-hand side, and hit it out of play. So an unforced error there from Jackie Burns. Carson Newman, 7.5 minutes to go. Right-footed cross coming in. Burns getting that touch right. Breathing down her neck was Williamson. Right at the top of the 6-yard box. Burns telling her team to hustle forward a little bit as she now rolls the ball on the ground. Burns will strike this ball looking for Talbot Smith. Instead, it's headed right back along. Kimmy Moore flares it to the sideline. Realista gets the touch, under 7 minutes to go. Good touch by Probst, but promptly taken off the ball. Now Mark Fort in the final 7 minutes of regulation. Realista has some space in front of her. Picks out Talbot Smith. Back for Realista. Goes out wide for an onside Rankin. Rankin looking to her left-hand side. Now takes a left-footed shot. On, and it's in! Kennedy Rankin strikes one home that could be the nail in the Bulldogs. What a strike by Rankin, who earlier had been denied from a similar spot, but this time the left-footed effort as she tracked back. Got a perfect touch, and it whizzed to the left-hand corner of the pocket. So Rankin scores in the 84th minute, and that is her third goal of the season, and the Eagles get the margin back to 2-3-1. The top seed in the SAC tournament back ahead by a pair. And now Wingate will try to charge. There's a foul whistled here. Eagles do bring Masengo back in. Jaden Zaff is also back in for a little defensive assistance. So a free kick coming here by the Bulldogs. They'll bring bodies into the box, but they still have three people back with Carson-Newman keeping Masengo and Talbot Smith out. Cross comes into the area, headed by Williams. Talbot Smith will win the race to get to this ball. It's a left-footed touch, but defended well initially by the Bulldogs. Winning possession back as this cross comes to the top of the area. Jackie Burns coming out, picking it up, and able to keep her momentum inside the 18-yard box. 85th minute. Carson Newman's lead is a pair. Two from Masengo, one from Rankin. And Jendrazik looked like she had Wingate on the right side, scoring in the 76th minute after Wingate fell behind 2-0. Masengo able to hold things up. Right to left switches. Now left-footed ball looking for Talbot Smith is pilfered by Pacello. Masengo, too strong, able to win that ball. Has opportunities forward, picks out Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith back for Masengo, ranking out wide. Instead, Masengo takes a left-footed blast that goes high and wide with under 5 minutes to go in regulation. The top seed trying to extend their winning streak in the SAC tournament to 10 games. Carson Newman has won each of the last three SAC tournament titles. Zapp touches it forward for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith able to angle it along. Plays it with the right foot for Masengo inside of the box. Masengo gives it right back for Talbot Smith. She crosses it through. Rankin tries to settle it down with a slide, but DiBiase able to clear it out. Wingate needs a charge, and they need one in the worst way with 4:15 to go here in regulation. Carson Newman, the top seed, has been able to seize control. Not once, but now for a second time. Realista stepping forward, finds Masengo. Masengo's got Talbot Smith wide open. She takes a right-footed shot and hits it high. Had a chance to make it 4-1, but also the flag was up for offsides. And for Talbot Smith, certainly an opportunity there, but couldn't keep herself on sides. At the very least, it does kill some time. 3.5 remaining. Wingate's got to go here. They got to find one here in a hurry. Instead, the Eagles again able to take it away with a field opened up. Advantage to the Eagles. Talbot Smith goes out wide for Rankin. She is on sides outside of the box. Rankin, who has already scored, gives it for Realista. Her right-footed chip is on, and it goes on top of the cage as Frail was chucking back and nearly needed that left paw to punch one over the top of the bar. Eagles will bring a sub in. Futrell will come in for Rankin. So Rankin providing the extra bit of cushion in the 84th minute. Steps off here in the 87th. Frail hits it. Ball skips off of Moore's head. Wingate needing to find a quick response, and the Eagles will pack in tightly along that back four. Masengo trying to hold it up. Mark Ford able to get to it. Go right back for Masengo, who alleviates the pressure. Gives it forward for Avery Williams. Now Brandon. Brandon, good touches in the middle of the area, finds Christina Markfort. Markfort out wide for Talbot Smith. Talbot Smith back for Markfort, has some space in front of her, carries the ball on and gives it for Talbot Smith. Right-footed shot hits the bar, and it's a goal kick in the final 2:35 of regulation. Carson Newman on top. Here with 2:25 showing on the clock. Eagles with three goals in the matter of about 11 minutes as a 3-1 lead. Masengo trying to hold it up and is whistled for a handball. Zapp will give the ball back. Right-footed ball cycling forward. Ball bouncing around here under 2 minutes to go. And now the Eagles just trying to play keep away as Talbot Smith will race here into the middle of the field. I think she wants the corner flag. Picks out Masengo right back in the middle of the area, and it's cleared forward. Touchdown by Brandon. Gives it back out wide for Masengo. Outside of the box, Masengo taking her time, holding the ball up. Nobody really providing a whole lot of pressure, and she can just maintain possession here and kill some time. Zapp in the middle of the field gives it away. And now Avery Williams will have to come back, rescue it with a header for Jaden Zapf. Williams has it bounce off of her shins and then keeps it alive, trickles it along the touchline for Brandon. 70 seconds remains in regulation. Doesn't look like Wingate has a charge as Masengo gets a couple touches. Top of the box, right-footed shot on. It hits the bar. Futrell there. She cleans it up and sends Carson Newman to the semifinals. The fourth goal of the match for the Eagles makes it 4-1. Ninth goal of the year for Emily Futrell, the sophomore. And with 61 seconds left, Carson Newman's offense coming alive. Had to earn this one against Wingate. Bulldogs made it 2-1, and certainly the Eagles starting to tighten up a little bit, but all of a sudden the Eagles were able to burst, and a long shot from Rankin made it 3-1, and the Eagles have been in cruise control since. Bulldogs not done yet, however, as Burns will step to it with 43 seconds left. And that should be the end of it here, with the exception of a couple more touches as Burns hits it out towards midfield. Eagles will continue their streak. Wingate has beaten Carson Newman one time in the SAC tournament. That came in 1996. Wingate will fail to get to a title game for the first time in their last 9 tries. Carson Newman, however, will get a chance for a fourth consecutive tournament title. Under 10 seconds left. The Eagles burst in the second half. Two goals from Masengo, one from Rankin, and one from Futrell. And Carson Newman continues its dominance of Wingate and the SAC with an opening round win, 4-1 the final here from McCowan Field. So Carson Newman picks up the victory here against the Bulldogs. The Eagles will get the early game on Friday. They'll be in action at 11 a.m. on Friday, and that game will come against, as of right now, as it stands, it is Catawba. The Indians are leading it 1-0 with 16:19 to go in regulation. Check CNEagles.com for the official opponent for Carson Newman in that contest. So we will have the official results here momentarily. Masengo 16th and 17th, Rankin's 3rd, and Futrell 9th has Carson Newman on the winning side. Our next broadcast starts in 6 minutes. Riley Thomas has the call from Holt Fieldhouse as Carson Newman Volleyball takes on LMU. We hope to see you over there at Holt as our cast and crew wraps things up here at McCowan Field. I'm Michael Watrang signing off as top-seeded Carson Newman extends its winning streak in the SAC tournament to 10 with a 4-1 win over the Wingate Bulldogs. We'll talk to you again shortly. Until then, good night, everybody.